Today I'm gonna show how we can get another amazing weapon, but also a really awesome shield. Probably most of the player will miss this weapon because it's something that you cannot get that easy. I'm gonna explain you exactly why. But just look at the damage. This is a weapon that it has a special ability of that blessing damage. The golden tempering is the special skill, and when you activate that skill, you're gonna hit with both of the weapons really fast. So we're gonna start the journey from the first step, and we have to defeat the that crafted scion. This is the first boss that we have to fight in Elden Ring, the crafted scion. But let me tell you something, most of the people will miss this weapon because you cannot defeat that boss from the start. You have to come back, and the only way to come back is to be here to the four belfries and just make your way that to that location that I just showed you on the map. You can rewind if you missed something. You have to use this key, it's a chest, and take the key, the inbred sword key. And with this inbred sword key, you'll have to go to the first tower and get teleported back to the first location. This is the only way of how you can be there, or you can finish the game, and with your new skills, with your new items, you can defeat that that boss like I did. But I'm gonna assume that most of the people are in the first game and they didn't defeat this one. If you already defeat the game, it will be easy to defeat that crafted scion. And from that one, you're gonna get a shield and a weapon. And it was just about time to make a video about it. I'm gonna explain what that special skill will do. We're gonna do a showcase, but let me tell you from the start, my ability, my skills, my points are not around this weapon. This is just a showcase. That's it. I don't have the best build to use that weapon. Now, you'll be teleported right over here to the left of the Stormveil Castle, to the location where you don't have a gray site. Yes, here you don't have a gray site to come back. So after you defeat this the boss from this area, all you have to do is to come back, to go back, upgrade your weapons if you like to do that, and just use them. Because yeah, I got those weapons and I forgot to use them, but now definitely I'm gonna use them more often because they're so amazing. I'm gonna explain why. Now, the location, the what you're seeing right now, it's when I just started my new game plus, and that crafted scion just appeared in front of me. Now I was prepared, and definitely it was an easy fight. I stayed a while to learn his move, to learn the move of this crafted scion, and as you can see, it's not the best warrior. I know if you are playing in the first minutes and you see this guy here, you're gonna be so beat, you don't know what it hit you. But let me tell you, after the new game plus, this guy is gonna seems like it's a really easy boss. It's a really easy champion. I just let him to learn his move. And as you can see, it has that jump move. It has something like a spinning with swords. But if you have a good incantation or a good spell that you can hit him from far away, definitely can. It will be so easy to defeat him. Now look at the move. It will jump and it will jump towards you. All you have to do is to dodge. I am pretty sure you can do that. Not like me. I'm not the best dodger in this game. I cannot dodge that good. But after I learn, I think it's a girl. Yeah, I know it's ugly. It's like a bug or something, like a spider, or I don't know. But the face is like a girl because I stay to watch his face. I pause it because I like to see the face of my enemies, and probably it's a girl. And that is the special ability of the sword, the one that you are seeing right now. And it will make your his attack faster, but I didn't let him to attack me with that. You're gonna get the ornamental straight sword, which is the sword that we are gonna talk today, but also you're gonna get that awesome shield. Now, let's just go to upgrade it. I'm gonna upgrade that sword to level 9, but shield I'm gonna leave it to level 0. I don't want to put points in that because I have a better shield. It's a really awesome shield for beginners if you don't have something else, but I already have another shield better than that. Now, these are the weapons. This is how they look like. I know they look quite small. And this will be the special ability of the weapon. Trust me, it's something really cool to see. And let's see the stats. Here we go. Cross the two swords to grant their attack Holy Essence. While in effect, strong attack per force, in a dual will... So basically you're gonna attack with both of the weapons and you'll have a damage boost. That's it, with the weapons. And plus the... Look how beautiful, not beautiful, look how nice it's that effect. With that gold effect, I absolutely love it. Or you know what, I can call it beautiful. Now let's find some enemies that we need to destroy. Remember, I cannot dodge that attacks, I'm not that good at that. But just enjoy the moves of the sword, look how fast they are and what special move we have. I noticed that are not that good against shields, these weapons. So be careful against big shields because they are not that good against that. But I was trying to go to different areas of the map to see different enemies and I noticed that these weapons are really, really good, especially in mid game. Look at this doggy. This is, in my opinion, a mid game enemy. And look how fast I just defeat that guy, only with a level 9 sword. Awesome or what? Tell me in the comments what do you think about this sword, if you like them, if you knew about them. Probably some of you knew about this one, but definitely I will have some of you that I'm gonna help with this video, that they didn't know about it and they didn't know about the skill that this weapon have. Okay, here we have a giant, but those arrows are so annoying. Those archers are keep shooting me. But look how much damage I can do to this big giant. Awesome. But those arrows, oh my god, nasty. Okay, that's it. I'm gonna show you also the stats of the shield because maybe you want to see that. I think there are have 100 physical resistance. Let's see. Let's check the shield. This is how it looks like. Yeah, probably it has physical resistance 100 max physical resistance. As you can see there, physical 100. But let me show you when I activate my shield, nothing can pass to that. It was not active. Let me do it. Now, as you can see, when it's active, you will not get damage. That's it. Thank you so much for watching. Like, subscribe, share if you enjoyed this video. And I'm gonna see you in the next one. Have a great day. Bye.